possible. Yep. All right. So should we all be hoarding food and buying gold? I do that already. Is the pandemic panic overblown? The party panel is back to discuss. Kat Timpf, Tyler Grant, Mattie Duppler. So Tyler, tell me about this. You're a lawyer. Who are you going to sue?
I think to some extent, people are overblowing the fact of the crisis. I mean, I think stocks indicate kind of a short-term perspective analysis of what people fear. Mm-hmm. And I think that overall these bounce back. I mean, SARS, Ebola, swine flu, bird flu, you know, you had the market reacting immediately and then the market realizing, okay, we can bounce back, we can ease back into buying. And, I think what it really boils down to is whether or not the Trump administration, whose plans to spend $2.1 billion to combat this. I mean, people are already being cured of this disease. You know, we talk a lot about the people that are infected, mm-hmm. but I mean, everybody that was infected in Vietnam has been cured. There's been a lot of people in China that have been cured. If it comes to the United States, I mean, we usually forget the fact that the Chinese live so close together. The amount of people that get infected by any amount of disease, virus, whatever, happens so small because of the condensity of the Chinese people so small relative to the United States. I mean, we're going to be able to react to this much, much faster. And the market, as long as supply lines aren't infected in some sort of
But that's the worry impact. Because we get so many of our drugs from China.
Right.
Heroin, meth,
all the fun
fentanyl.
Ones, correct, yes. So in some sense, maybe, and I say maybe very strong here, but maybe it's helpful that we had the trade war leading up until this year because companies have already started to shift some of their supply chains out of China.
Yes.
That is the question, though, moving forward, because most experts looking at this year's economy were saying any recession worries, they had backed off of those because the economy looked good, the global economy looked good. That one big pressure of U.S.-China trade was finally relenting. Mm-hmm. With the coronavirus, that is a black swan event, meaning it's an event that comes out of nowhere. We don't know how long it's going to run.
And you can't necessarily control it.
Correct.
But is the economy, is our economy strong enough to
withstand it? Our economy is absolutely 100 strong enough to withstand it. The question is if our politics are strong enough to withstand it. Mm. A black swan event is more important than what it does to our political lenses. Exactly. Than what it does to the actual economy. The economy will be able to undertake this no problem. It's whether or not Trump gets blamed for the response to it. You said $2.1 billion request coming from Washington. Let's see how Washington handles the response to this and what that does to voter attitudes moving into
the summer. Is it going to be like the Bush response to Hurricane Katrina?
It would be totally unfair to blame Trump for a bad economy. I mean, he gets to take all the credit when it's good.
That's what you do.
But you can't have him take credit when it's bad.
Nope.
You got to stop being such a never Trumper. No, it would be bad for him, but
do you have
TDS? Take credit. TDS?
Yeah.
Oh, no, I don't think I have TDS. Mm-hmm. I just think I have consistency DS.
There's a vaccine for that, too.
I'm not concerned about the coronavirus, and it's not because I think I'm one of these healthy people that can beat it. I woke up on Saturday with my back and neck really hurting, and I still haven't been able to move my head fully. That's not the mark of a healthy person.
But it's also not the mark of someone who's not coronavirus.
Exactly.
We have 10 seconds.
Don't worry about coronavirus. Something else is going to kill you.
Yay! Words to live and die by. Thank you so much, Mattie, Tyler, and Kat. And happy Mardi Gras. We'll be back later. Coming up, should the feds be spying?